just about set to kick off. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He scrambles. And down he goes, around the 33-yard line.
That makes it 7-6.
Second and six. Ball on their own 33. Now he tries to buy some time. Dives, and he's down.
He did a good job of recognizing that he was the best option for picking up the first.
Job by the big guys up front to use their size and speed and get the runner in the backfield.
From their own 38-yard line, second down. He's scrambling. And he's taken down at the 47-yard line.
You know, he had his receiver open. He just put too much on that football. He's got to find a little bit more touch next time.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. He's out to the 30. Tries to get around the corner. He makes it to the 38-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Zips it to the tight end. He's tackled at about the 49. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49. The middle. Good outside run there.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
Around the 38-yard line. So they'll pick up a first down there on a 7-yard completion.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
From the 38-yard line, first down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Out to about the 17-yard line. From the 17-yard line, first down. And they make the stop at the 8.
That brings in 2nd and 9.
Cover tight. Go down.
Watch your team.
Down.
Hold down.
Close
down.
Close
down.
Decent pickup. Here's the eighth play of the series. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Throws complete. Touchdown. Change your quarterback, Kirby. You got to wonder what that's going to do to the team morale. It is next man up. They've got to be ready to trust this guy. And he tacks on the extra point. Nice eight play, 61-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. They line up to kick this one away. You've got to love the way this football game has started for this team. They put a lot of work into it. It's working for them. Right?
Yeah, they've been able to capture the momentum of this game early. It's such a pivotal part of winning a college football game is holding on to that now. Let's just see if they're able to maintain it.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 27. Pass is tipped away. Great range as he's able to break up the pass.
I know that the safety makes a good play here, but as a receiver, you got to get in there and play some defense. He's lucky that one wasn't intercepted.
Moves up in the pocket and down he goes. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. And he's tackled at the 44-yard line. It's 2nd down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Here's the halfback. He's at the 30. He's pushed out of bounds around the 22-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 22. On the corner. Inside the 10, and he's in the end zone. Touchdown. Very impressive run by the halfback to find the end zone.
Good play call here by the offensive coordinator. He realizes when you get down into the red zone and you have a halfback like this, just give him the ball and let him find his way into the end zone.
And he converts the extra point with a 3-play, 52-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Well, the blocking up front was just amazing. I think that's what led them to those big runs.
So our score, 14-0. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line.
Kirk, they say if you don't let the other team score, you're going to win. You can't lose. That's what's going on so far.
Well, this defense is bending a bit, but they're not breaking. They're off to a great start, keeping their offense and this team in a position to be able to win this game. Let's see if they can maintain it.
Well, you know the offense would like to generate more than they did on their last possession.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle made at the 25-yard line.
This is a great pitch and catch combination, and they hook up here for a big-time game.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. So at the end of one, the Wolfpack lead 14-0. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Up the middle for a nice game.
Second and six.
It's second and six. Ball on the 21-yard line. They'll bring him down the 20-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And they hit him in the backfield. Unable to pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands.
And the defense looked like they were expecting option on that play. Great job to pin him up and cause the turnover on downs.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Under pressure. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
Now, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
It's second and 10. Ball on their own 21.
See if this coaching staff sticks with the short passing game, or if they decide to open it up a bit more.
They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 31. It's first and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. Gets to about the 34-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back. To go. Ball on the 41. On the ground, right side. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
Nice run up the middle. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And that will make it fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
Takes it in at the 14. And he just got stood up right there. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime.
He's going to try and scramble. Decides to slide. And he tucked that one in for about 5 yards.
That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Up the middle for a nice run.
They should continue to run the ball. If they keep this up, the defense will wear down very quickly.
Now he's scrambling, and he's sacked.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. It seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They'll knock him down for a loss. So he decides to hold on to it, and it goes nowhere. The defense calls a timeout.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one.
He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession. He gets rid of this one. From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. Scrambling around, slides down. He wants it all, going long. For the 10, touchdown! The PAT. A short three-play, 61-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. The score now, 21-0. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. They'll bring him down at the 31-yard line. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. Caught, open field, out of bounds at the 39.
That makes it second.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Now he tries to buy some time. He's at midfield, slides down to the ground. Nebraska will have one timeout remaining. Throws to the tight end, and that ball's incomplete.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
From the 48-yard line, second down. He's scrambling. 4 yards there on the scramble. He's on the run. And he's going to be sacked. First half is over, and this is why they play the game. 21-0, Wolfpack.
everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, trying to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm going to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Inside the 30, the 10. Touchdown, huge play. What a big time return for that young man. Tackled at the 29-yard line. You know, sometimes you see defenses play good in stretches. This has been the longest stretch I've seen one defense play in a football game in a long time.
Yeah, I think the consistency is the thing that stands out. I think they got off to a great start at halftime. They made a few adjustments, and they've come out even played better, believe it or not, here in this second half.
Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose. He's to the 40. Makes it to the 41. From their own 41-yard line. First down. Good protection, and now he's on the run. Brought down right around the 44-yard line. Scrambled. He's tackled right around midfield. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
These two coordinators are going back and forth between the offense and the defense. And that time, the defensive coordinator, I think, had a good idea of what was coming, put his players in position to make a play, and give those players a lot of credit. They played that third down with a lot of energy and really an aggressive attitude to be able to stop that play. I'm not sure the offense had much of a choice here. It was a pretty short conversion. The defense just made a good play.
You really can't say enough about this defense. Fourth and short, and they really showed up on that play. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Tackle after a decent pickup. From the 42-yard line, second down.
It's always a plus if you're able to pick up the first down with the running game.
backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers.
Fires incomplete.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
Knocked out of bounds at the 32. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. They come out in an empty backfield. Makes the grab, past the marker, and he's tackled right away.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Makes it out to about the 13. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Watch the team. Watch the team. Watch the team. You waiting.
Tries to get around the corner. He's pushed out of bounds at the 4. And this is the 8th play of the drive. His third touchdown catch of the ball game.
Yeah, this guy is in his zone. He's catching every single ball thrown his way.
He makes the PAT. A nice 8-play, 46-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Nebraska is getting stomped right now. They're unable to get anything going here in the third quarter.
Well, I think what they have to do at this point is they've got to get into a little bit more of a hurry-up mode, a little bit more urgency, score, and hope that the defense can come up with a stop and hope you can get the ball back and put more points on.
Now he's flushed and they got it.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Just throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Tosses out to the tailback on the screen. And down he goes around the 22-yard line. The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. And he's taken down at the 46-yard line. Nebraska has done everything right in this football game, at least to this point.
Yeah, at this point is a key. We still have an entire quarter to go, but they have executed perfectly on both sides of the ball. They've got a nice lead here. They're thinking about upset.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
And he's tackled at the 48. Second down and 12. Ball on the 48. At about the 35. That's a great tackle at the 34. Second and 9. Ball on the 34. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. And they make the stop at the 31. And it's caught. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
One quarter to go before they turn the college football world upside down. 35-0. Not sure there's any hope for a comeback here in the fourth quarter, but Kirk and I are praying. Defensive coordinator anticipating this 5-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Fires out to his wideout. He's at the 20. Tackle made right around the 18-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 18-yard line. The 5. They go back to him on a quick throw.
Okay, so they've got this one well in hand. I think now is the time where you call off the dogs and stop airing it out.
And he converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This defensive end has been a force, Kirk.
Well, this guy seems to just be the spark plug for this defense. They seem to go when they play depending on the vibe and energy that he brings. And today, boy, he is bringing. And he's shown tremendous effort and determination in racking up these tackles.
If you want to point to certain individuals as reasons why they're winning, he'd be a good start. I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. He's going to try and scramble. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. They'll bring him down right around the 40. It's first and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. And he shoved out of bounds at the 46. Steps out of bounds at the 49. Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 1. He makes it out to midfield. He's got room. He goes out of bounds around the 44-yard line. So it's 2nd down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Look at a scramble now. He can't get away from the pressure. Here's the 8th play of the series. the middle for a nice gain. Third down again. Just under three to go in regulation. Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
Nine times out of ten, the defense will make a stop on that play. But, you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. He's taken down at the 48-yard line. Out to around the 38. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run. This one's in the books, and our final score, 42-0. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.